When we look around us, we can notice that there are many things we used to do, and there are different creatures we used to see every day. But did we think once about them? Or did we question what kind of relation relates us to them? Nothing in this world is for nothing. Everything has a wisdom of its existence. This could be a perfect capture for your Snapchat story or amazing scene for your project. But every capture has a story behind it. These most popular creatures around the world have memories with human beings throughout history. All available evidence shows that from the time primitive human first domesticated animals, the pigeon was regarded as the highest of all speechless creatures. It shows that pigeons are among the first of any animals and the first of all birds to be domesticated. Many people today would be surprised to know that there are over 300 breeds of domestic pigeons, all originating from one wild source, the rock dove. Records and carvings of doves have been found as early as 3000 before Christ, but some argue that domestication may have taken place as long as 10,000 years ago. To archaeological records, such as terracotta figures found in present-day Turkey, dating from the 5th century. Throughout the history, pigeon has used in various fields. Over millennia, pigeon served as messengers and a food source, and used to represent images of love, peace, the Holy Spirit, and even heroism. For example, pigeons were regarded as sacred among the ancient Syrians and Assyrians. That is, as soon as agriculture began in regions containing wild rock pigeons, these pigeons made their way to human settlements and foraged for grain. Even as they used them for food or fertilizer, they began to explore other functional and leisure possibilities for these birds. As a consequence of this domestication and the interactions between pigeons and humans, it led to the gradual accumulation of a stock of knowledge of the pigeon's traits. Such interactions also led to useful discoveries by humans, such as the value of pigeon guano as fertilizer. As the value of the pigeon became apparent, it became a commodity. The rock dove is naturally gifted with an ability to find its way home from faraway places, relying on abilities beyond memorization. Humans discovered this capability by accident. When pigeons released far from home, either given or traded to someone or abandoned, found their way back to where they had previously lived. And it is this unique ability of the pigeon that has perhaps become the most legendary. This discovery became the foundation for increased domestication of pigeons aimed at new instrumental ends, which led to their proliferation to new locals and new moral valuation. Hundreds of stories document the heroic character of these birds that saved human lives. The first modern war, World War I, witnessed the use of phone and telegraph lines to send crucial messages in record speed between the front lines and command centers. Yet, communication lines were repeatedly destroyed or trapped by the enemy. Thus, homing pigeons were used on an unprecedented scale. In fact, pigeons were seen as so valuable or dangerous in enemy hands that the Germans ordered all pigeons destroyed when they occupied Belgium and France. By the time World War II occurred, even with advanced in technology, pigeons were of major value. For example, Britain dropped birds from a plane into occupied France and Belgium. With luck, a sympathetic civilian in the occupied territory would find the bird in time, read the message, and take the risk of providing any known details about enemy positions or other helpful information. After filling out the survey, the individual would release the pigeon for its return flight over the sea to England. Pigeons were even strapped to the chest of American paratroopers during the D-Day invasion, bringing the first news of the invasion of England along with the position of enemy rocket launching sites. where this use was a temporary for the purpose of performing something was needed in that time, but what remained is the sophisticated use of pigeon, which was magnificently appeared and permitted in the human culture. It is the metaphor use of pigeon that express the deep meaning of love and loyalty. It is a biological fact that a pair of pigeons, once mated, usually remain and only mate with each other. While humans began to exploit this natural trait for the selective breeding of squab, a flow effect of pigeons' management habits was their candidacy for anthropomorphism. Thus, initial breeding for conception began to have an anticipated impact on social narratives. Monogamy is historically a morally valued trait in many societies. The fact that pigeons, unlike many other animals, display this trait resulted in positive moral evaluations of these animals by ancient civilizations. Their monogamous habits led to their use in rituals and shrines that celebrate love. Today, pigeons still are used to represent love. It is popular to release white pigeons at weddings, as well as at funerals to represent peace and soul's eternity. It is often used as a symbol of peace. How? In modern times, the status of the dove as a symbol of peace was disseminated when Picasso painted a single white dove on a poster advertising the 1949 World Peace Congress. Why are pigeons so represented? Doves, in particular, have always appealed to us with their attractive looks and gentle cooing sounds. And that, based on the positive functions that this pigeon served for human civilizations, the character of this bird was constructed in morally positive, even sacred terms. Birds helped people to cure their loneliness, and storks, pigeons, sparrows, and swallows used to fearlessly make their nests on rooftops of chimneys of any building. The various functional roles of pigeons throughout time and space are associated with social meanings ascribed to pigeons. One says that animals are indeed a blank paper which can be inscribed with any message and symbolic meaning that the social wishes. What could be expected after this deep relation with pigeons than a respect and a complete care of them? Here it is, Turkey, particularly Istanbul, where the center of the amazing historical legacy exists. ¶¶ This city witnessed a very noticeable care of animals generally and birds particularly. In the literature, this value given to the birds indicates to stem both from the religious identity of Ottomans and the Turkish culture inherited from the Central Asia. In the Ottoman state, charitable foundations and hospitals were established for the treatment and management of diseased birds, and special constructions and shelters were built for convenience of birds. The Ottomans established foundations, wakf, for helping street dogs to find food, birds to drink water on hot days, storks to be treated when they are injured, wolves to be fed with meat, or wounded horses to receive treatment. And more importantly, they built bird houses on the facades of mosques, madrasas, or palaces that had sunlight and no wind at a height that people could not reach. These bird houses were designed to shelter any bird flying freely around, such as sparrows, wisecracks, swallows, pigeons, and storks. They also placed small plates on graves from which birds could drink water.
Here we are in Eyüp Sultan Mosque, one of the most popular places in Istanbul. Adın ne?
Elanur.
Nasılsın? Ne yapıyorsun?
Kuşları yem veriyorum.
Niye yem veriyorsun?
Onların karnı acıktığı için.
Hava soğuk. Yağmur yağıyor, yani yemek bulmaları çok zor kışın. Bütün hayvanların, sadece kuşların değil. Hani imkanımız varken Allah rızası için onları. Yani çok zor yemek bulmaları hayvanların kışın. En önemli nedeni o.
Ama bir şey sorabilir miyim? Niye yemler atıyorsunuz?
Yesin hayvanlar diye. Kuş. Ha, evden getireyim ben bunu her zaman. Çok sevap Peygamber Efendimiz'in mübarekler.
Mübarekler mi?
Tabii. Eyüp Hazreti Bey çok. Sen nereden geldi bunlar? Bunlara vermek çok sevap.
Decorating the facets of the buildings with birdhouses can be seen in the classical Ottoman architecture as early as 13th century. However, most elegant pieces appear in the 18th and 19th century. Now we are going to the Europe side of Turkey, to the Eminönü. We will see another scene of birds-human relationship. This is the Eminönü Mosque. It was built in 1665 back to the Sultan Murad III. And here we can see the bird houses, which comes back to the Ottoman Empire. This is another type of bird houses called the dovecotes. It's a shelter where the birds can save themselves, and it is very popular in Turkey. Ottoman bird palaces are usually found on the public buildings such as mosques, madrasas, inns, houses, bridges, libraries, and tombs. According to researchers, bird palaces are unique facet elements to Turkish architecture, and there are not similar examples in any other culture. For instance, in the 15th century, the Sultan Muhammad Fatih announced a decision states that when there is a building project, like mosques or public buildings, they have to contain houses for the birds. On the same approach, when Sultan Abdul Majid had a Dolmabahçe Palace constructed in 1856, he chose a more modern version of the birdhouse, the outdoor aviary. Located in the western city of Bursa, the Gurbahani Laklakan, the home of homeless Turks, which still stands, was built to treat wounded Turks centuries ago. Consequently, the Turkish nation and the territories that were under the control of Ottoman Empire also inherit this humanitarian habit. We have been talking about the birdhouses and its history, but what about the people who are responsible, or the real responsible, of ensuring and bringing this feed to the birds? What they feel and how they work? This is what we are gonna learn.
Ben Romanım. Roman çingenesiyim. Arnavut çingenesiyim. Evet.
Şey Sedam, kaç yıldır bunu?
60 sene.
Bu emin miydi mi?
Evet, 60 sene Eminönü'nde yem sattım. 60 sene.
Niye? Bu iş.
Ben evlenmeden oturdum. Yem satıyordum. Ufaktım. 7 yaşında, 8 yaşında vardı, 9 yaşında. Yeme oturdum.
Hangi saatte geliyorsunuz
buraya? 8'de geliyoruz, 7'de geliyoruz.
Sabah. Ne zaman dönüyorsunuz eve?
Şimdi saat 4-5 dedi mi gidiyorsun.
Peki bunların belediye mi veriyor?
Yok.
Siz mi? Nereden getiriyorsunuz?
Buradan alıyoruz, yemcilerden alıyoruz. Yemcilerden alıyoruz.
Peki belediye size hiç desteklemiyor mu?
Allah razı olsun. Onun sayesinde oturduk.
Kışta işin nasıl oluyor?
Ben kışın gelmiyorum.
Kışta?
Şimdi... Kışın yağmur, kar yağdım ben yokum.
Niye?
Soğuk. Ben durmam,
peki,
ben hastayım.
Peki nasıl ekmek parası nereden?
Ekmek işte karakolundan alıyoruz, yiyoruz. Evet.
Peki sence niye insanlar buraya geliyorlar, yağ veriyorlar? Şey?
Kuşlara hayırına, sebabına. Hayır, sebap. Niyet ediyorsun, niyetin oluyor, geliyor buradan yemlerip döküyorsun. Sen şimdi bana acıdın, attın yemi, verdin bana bu kadar para. Helal ediyoruz birbirimize, anladın mı?
Bu işi 3 yıldır yapıyorum.
Önceden?
Fotoğrafçıyım.
Ne zaman geliyorsun buraya? Buraya ne zaman geliyorsun?
Sabah. Hı-hı. Sabah 7.30'da buradayım.
Ne zaman dönüyorsun?
Akşam 5'te biraz sonra giderim.
Peki abi sence insanlar niye buraya geliyorlar, yan veriyorlar kuşlara?
Burası dünyanın merkezi.
Ama şeyde Eyüp'te de geliyorlar.
Tamam da dünyanın merkezi. Anne demek
ki
orada da kuş var.
Evet.
Beyazıt'ta kuş var.
Evet.
Şeyde kuş var ama dünyanın merkezi. Hani gözü burası. Eminönü, Fatih.
Kaçak olarak normalde çocukluğumda başladım bu işe. Kaçak olarak satıyordum.
Kaçak olarak?
He. Daha sonra da resmi olarak da 2009'dan beri bu işi yapıyorum. Eyüp Sultan'da mezarlıklarda büyüdüm. Orada yattım. Belediye başkanlarımız burada bize sahip çıktı.
Bir tane
İnsanlar da vesile oldu buna. Sağ olsun yardımcı oldular bize. Biz de bu işi hakkıyla yerine getirmeye çalışıyoruz. Müşteri mi?
Hadi alın bakalım beraber.
Yani 100 lira, 50 lira, 60 lira, yeri geliyor yani değişiyor rakamlarımız. Hamdolsun aç kalmıyoruz, evimizde çorbamız pişiyor.
Because that bird houses are an element of Ottoman era architecture, with their intricate designs and tiny architecture, whoever visit Istanbul will notice these small houses on the walls, especially mosques walls. The oldest birdhouse in Istanbul is located on the Büyükçekmece Bridge. A very featured habit of the Ottoman Turkish culture is the throwing wheat grain on the top of the mountains when snow falls, so that birds do not die of hunger in the winter cold. It is believed that the 8th Umayyad Caliph, Umar bin Abdul Aziz, said, "Spread wheat on the tops of mountains, so it cannot be said that a bird went hungry in the land of Muslims."
We are in our way to Üsküdar on the Anatolian shore of Bosphorus. here in Üsküdar, in very narrow street, there is this huge mosque. Its name Ayazma. It was built in 1760. There were different shapes of the bird houses. One of the popular ones is the palace shape, like the one in the Ayazma mosque. And the other is the mosque shape, and it's also very popular in Istanbul.
Birds have left deep traces in the history of culture and remained as a decisive element in art, which is one of the most important expressions of man. And the Turkish Ottoman culture has left a production of birds in art culture not witnessed in any other geography.
We are actually talking about a great historical inheritance designed very carefully in aesthetic way.
With wishful to stay and continue.